Hello, boys and girls. This is Aunt Fernita. Today's story is called Seashore Song. The memory verse is from Exodus chapter 15, verse 1. It says, I will sing to the Lord, for He is highly exalted. The message is God loves and cares for us. Have you ever been scared or frightened and did not know what to do? That is just how the children of Israel felt at the beginning of our story. Read on to find out how their fear was transformed into joy. The Israelites were trapped, and they were afraid. Pharaoh and his army were behind them. In front of them was the Red Sea. They felt certain that they would drown or be taken back to Egypt as slaves. As they camped by the Red Sea, God's angel and the pillar of cloud that had been showing them the way moved behind them. Throughout the night, one side of the cloud kept Pharaoh's army in darkness. On the other side, the cloud looked like fire and gave light and warmth to the Israelites. Pharaoh's army could not get near them. The Lord told Moses to stretch out his hand over the sea. All night long, God sent a wind to blow back the sea. The wind caused the sea to divide. When it was almost morning, the Israelites walked through the sea. Walls of water stood to their right and to their left, but the ground where they walked was dry. Pharaoh's army followed the Israelites into the sea, but the Lord made them panic. Suddenly, their chariots would not move. God is with the Israelites, they screamed. Let's get away from them. But they could not. Again, God said to Moses, hold your hand over the sea. He did, and the walls of water came crashing down, and all of Pharaoh's army drowned. When the Israelites saw this, they could hardly believe their eyes. They were so relieved and happy. Everyone started singing and praising God. Their song told how God saved them from Pharaoh's army. Let's sing it together. I will sing to the Lord because He is worthy of great honor. He has thrown the horse and its rider into the sea. The enemy bragged, I will chase them and catch them. But you blew on them with your breath and covered them with the sea. They sank like lead into the powerful water. Are there any gods like you, Lord? No, there are no gods like you. You are wonderfully holy. You are amazingly powerful. You do great miracles. You keep your loving promise. You lead the people you have saved. With your strength, you will guide them to your holy land. Lord, that is the place that you made for yourself to live. Lord, that is the temple that your hands have made. The Lord will rule forever. Moses and Aaron's sister Miriam was so happy, she grabbed her tambourine and started dancing and singing. All the other women played their tambourines and danced and sang with her. Miriam sang, sing to the Lord, for He is worthy of great honor. He has thrown the horse and its rider into the sea. Moses, Miriam, and the Israelites sang about two things at the same time. They sang about being saved while crossing the Red Sea. They may have also been looking forward and singing about the future, how God will save His children and take them to heaven. We can all sing the song. We too can celebrate. God has helped His family through the ages. He continues to help us today, and He will help us in the future.
This podcast is read by Franita Buddy for Gracelink.net, created and produced by Falvo Fowler, post-produced by Faith Toe at Studio El Piso. The theme music is by Clayton Kinney. Animation and artwork by Giogo Godoy. The audio engineer was Karel Holness. For more information, please visit gracelink.net.